Hello, my name is Akshay Nagre. There are two different types of 3D scanners available. One contact type and another one is non-contact type 3D scanner. We have built a non-contact type 3D scanner. The main aspects of our 3D scanning project are to increase the speed of operation, improve the quality of scan data, and to decrease the overall cost of 3D scanning process. The scan data, which we call as point cloud, can be transferred from one machine to another machine easily.
Hi everyone, my name is Vedant Rakshe and I am going to explain you the components which were used in our project. I am going to start with the SMPS. So this is the SMPS and the specification for this SMPS are the input required is a 240 volt AC and the output is 48 volt DC. So this 48 volt DC is connected to the driver. So here you can see the driver. These are the connections for DC input, which is 48 volt DC. Now this is the driver which I used during project. The specification for this driver are it is giving us the 5 ampere output current and the 48 volt DC. Here is the motor which is connected below the turntable. You can see this is the stepper motor and the input for the stepper motor is 48 volt DC and the current required is 5 ampere. So now this motor is connected to the driver. Also these drivers have the pins connected to the Raspberry Pi. So we are controlling the motor using Raspberry Pi. So these are the connections. This is the Raspberry Pi module 3. This is the object which are going to rotate. You can see here is the red line. This is basically the strip laser. You can see the strip laser. So this is the strip laser, red strip laser. Having the input voltage required is 5 volt and the power is 2 milliwatt and the angle with the angle with the result laser is emitting angle is greater than 90 degree. So you can see the camera also is at some angle with the laser. This angle is 162 degree and the distance from the camera and the object is 56 centimeter and the distance from the laser and the object is 55 centimeter. This is because and the camera is at some angle with the laser because we want to capture the whole object. So according to the specification of the camera, the horizontal angle of the camera is 76 degree and the vertical angle is 42 degree. This is the field of vision of the camera. So because of that, we have mounted the camera at some angle with the laser and the plane of and this is the center of turntable. Here you can see the Raspbian OS of Raspberry Pi and these are all the codes which we have used which are present on the Raspberry Pi. From here we need to execute this file. So a terminal will open, it will show waiting for the connection and this is the another desktop. Here we are reconstructing the image. These are the some coordinates we have already reconstructed. You can see these coordinates. So these are the final coordinates. But the image is not fully scanned. Hi everyone. Now I am going to demonstrate with the process. To start the process, first we need to execute this file. This is a .exe file. It will open one terminal. And from this terminal, we can see whether the installation process is completed or not. This is a Raspberry Pi Raspbian OS. So the installation is completed. I am waiting for the connection. So from our reconstruction software, we need to connect to the scanner. And the process has been started. So you can see the 3D points on the desktop. And the object has been start rotating at the angle of 1.8 degree. So after every 1.8 degree, we are capturing an image. But the image we are getting is a 2D image. And we are interested only on the red pixels from the image. So to obtain the remaining Z coordinate of the object, we have created one lookup table. So basically a lookup table is created using the intersection of a plane and a vector. So the plane is the laser plane and the vector is extended from the center of the camera. So intersection of a plane and a vector will give us a point and using 3D geometry we are getting the third coordinate, that is the Z coordinate of the object. And if we give input as X and Y coordinate to the lookup table, it will give us the 3D coordinate of the respective pixel. And that 3D coordinate, we have created a buffer of the 3D coordinate and we have sent it to the desktop. And this is how we are creating an image, scanned image. So this is the process we are following. It will take total 200 steps to scan to scan object. Now you can see 194 steps have been completed and only 5 steps are remaining. So after 200 steps it will stop. So this is a 3D object, scan 3D object.
Hi, I am Vishwadya Mintlal. I am going to deal with certain challenges which that we faced. Firstly, the laser light which we used was having lots of noise when incident on the object. As well as the light which was incident was observed by the webcam as white colored. For this issue to be solved, we used a circular polarizer which was used to adjust the intensity, as well as the red pixels were identified as red by the webcam. Second issue was the disc which we used as turntable was too much bulky, as well as its total inertia was much larger. So to reduce this problem of jerking while rotation, we used two supports below the disc, as well as we made a disc which was smaller in size, having less inertia. Third thing is that appropriate lighting conditions. Our project requires dark conditions so as to obtain high efficiency 3D points of the object.
Hi, myself Tushar Mistri. We are proposed to build a mechanical assembly with 3D scan and turntable only. So we have completed that part. We have also established the connection between the Raspberry Pi and the Windows. Right now we are getting the complete point cloud of an object, but still we are missing some of the points, so we are working to get those points in the point cloud. The point cloud that we are getting has an identical shape as that of the object which we are going to scan, but we have not measured the accuracy of the objects.
Hi, myself Tushar Mistri. Nowadays the available 3D scanner are too much costly. Our 3D scanner will overcome this problem because we are going to use the component which are cheap. Including all this, our product cost is around 70,000 rupees. We can further reduce this cost if we brought this product into mass production.
Our project idea is basically a combination of important engineering branches like electrical, electronics, computer and mechanical, which work together in synchronization to form a complete scanner model. Secondly, the scanners which are available in India nowadays are mostly imported from Germany and alike companies, which are mostly preferred by the industries due to their precision and accuracy. Therefore, our project looks forward towards the development of scanner industry in India. The other thing that is important is that our 3D scanner can be used as a 3D profilometer in the mechanical industry. 3D profilometer basically takes a precise 3D profiles of any object which is present in mechanical assembly or such things. So that is much useful for mechanical industry as well. Other things are such as usability, reliability and cheap design of our project makes it a perfect fit for to be selected.